Hello, welcome back to Scaffold Design for Scaffolders. I'm Alejandro Garcia, and today I will solve the three exercises I gave you at the end of lesson 8. If you haven't watched the previous video, please do so now. Solve the exercises yourself and then come back to check the answers. Let's go with the first one. We have a bridge with an 8 meter span, a 2 kN per meter line load, and a 20 kN point load. As usual for bridges with pin supports, well, in this case we have a roller support and a pin support, we will have two vertical reactions. There will be also a horizontal reaction, but since we don't have any horizontal loads, we don't bother. Let's get first the reactions, as usual, with two static equations. The summation of vertical loads and moments on support A. So let's go first with the vertical loads. We have reaction on A plus reaction on B are going to be equal to 20 kN plus the line load. But the total load caused by the line load is going to be the line load times the length. In this case, the whole span. So that's 20 plus 16. So we have 36 kilonewtons. Now, moments on A. We have, if you go from the right towards the left, we will have reaction on B times 8 meters. And then we have the line load. This case is going to be negative. So that's 2 kN per meter times 8 meters. And then the distance from the center of the line load is going to be 4 meters. And then we also have the 20 kN times 6 meters. And this must be equal to 0 because it's a roller support. So now we can calculate that reaction on B is going to be equal to 2 times 8, 16 times 4, 64. Plus 120 divided by 8. And that's just to check, we have 23 kilonewton. And now, since we know that RA plus RB equal 36, then we can say that RA equals 36 minus 23, so 13 kilometers. Okay, so we always start the same way, static equations to obtain the reactions, and now we proceed to calculate the moments along the beam. Let's calculate the moments. So we are going to calculate the moment equation from 0 to 6 and then from 6 to 8. So we are cutting where we have different loads. So at the start, we are having the reaction on A times x. And we also have the light loop that is going to vary depending of how long along the beam we go. And this is going with a minus. So 2 times x for the total load due to the light load, and then the liberal arm is going to be half the distance. So x divided by 2. So if we want to calculate the value for x equals 6 meters, we can say that m at 6 equals 13 times 6 minus 2 times 6 times 6 divided by 2. That's 42 kilonewton meter. And now for the rest, the moment due to the reaction, as before, is 13 times x. We must subtract again the light load, so 2 kilonewton per meter times x squared divided by 2, same as before. And now we also have the 20 kN point load. It's going to be again with a minus, so 20 kN times x minus the 6 meters to the beginning. So if we want to check at the end, at support B, we should get a moment equal to 0. So just to double check, moment at 8 equals 13 times 8 minus 2 times 8 squared divided by 2 minus 20 times 8 minus 6. And that's exactly 0. Okay, so that's for the first one. If you didn't get it right, just try it again. And if you have any issues, ask me on the comments. Let's go to the second one. Exercise 2. A 6 meter span with 0.2 km per meter line load and 3 point loads. This could be the real case of a bridge scaffold. As before, we have two vertical reactions, and we are going to first calculate the reactions and then the moments. So for the reactions, as before, two static equations with vertical loads and moments. RA plus RB must be equal to the point loads, so 10 kN plus 9 kN plus 9 kN, and the light load, that's 0.2 kN per meter times 6 meters. And that's a total of 29.2 kilonewton. Now, moments on B. Let's start with RA. So we have RA times 6 meters. And then the rest are going with a minus because they turn on the opposite direction. So 10 kN. Times 5 meters. Then we have 9 kN times 3 meters. Another 9 kN times 1.5 meters. And then just the light load. So 0.2 kN per meter times 6 meters and times 3 meters. And from here we can calculate RB. That equals just adding up here, we have 50 plus 27 plus 13.5 plus 3.6 divided by 6. Yeah, and that's 1568 kilonewton. So if RB is 15.6, oh sorry, RA, not RB, RA is 15.68, then RB equals 13.52 kN. Okay, sorry about the mistake. So now we have both reactions. Let's calculate the moments. If I find the stop button. So we have calculated the reactions. Now let's obtain the moment equation. From 0 to 1 meter, we have the reaction on A and the line. So I'm going to do 15.68 times x, and then with the minus sign we will have the line load times x squared divided by 2. And from here we will obtain a value on 1 equal to 15.58. Newton meter. From 1 to 3, we have the same as before, minus 0.2 x squared divided by 2, and now we add the 10 kN boilload. So 10 times x minus the 1 meter. And if we input x equal 3, we get a moment equal to 26.14 kilonewton meter. Now, between 3 and 4.5, before the reactions times the distance, minus the line load, we have the first boil load again times x minus 1, and now we have another boil load times x minus 3. And if we calculate with x equals to 4.5 meters, we will obtain a moment equal to 20.04 kilonewton meter. And now the last one. I'm just repeating so it's easier to learn and understand. So as before, reaction times the distance. We remove the line load, 0.2 times x squared divided by 2. First point load, then times x minus 1, minus the second point load, times x minus 3. And the last one, another 9 kN, times x minus 4.5. Now, if we apply x equals 6 to this equation, we should get 0. Let's check it. So I don't get zero exactly. What I get is minus 0.02. Okay. Why is that? Because the real value of the reactions is not 15.68. For example, for A is 15.68333. So just because I'm using only two decimal digits, I don't get the exact answer, but 0.02 is close enough to zero for this exercise. Now let's go with the third one. Exercise 3. 9 meter span with 3 poilots. As before, two vertical reactions. So first we calculate the reactions and then the moments. So summation of vertical loads. We have that RA plus 3 kN plus RB must equal 2 kN plus 2 kN. And now taking moments on A, we have minus 2 kN times 1 meter plus 3 kN times 6 meters minus 2 kN times 8 meters and now plus 9 meters times RP and this must equal 0. So now we can calculate RB are going to equal to 18 minus 18 divided by 9. So that's 0. So if RB equals 0, then we have that RA equals 1 kN. Okay, so 1 kN for RA, 0 for RB. Let's now calculate the moments. Now let's calculate the moment diagram. From 0 to 1, we only have the reaction. So this is going to be 1 kN times x. So obviously, if we calculate the moment after 1 meter, we are getting 1 kilonewton per meter. Now between 1 and 6, we have the reactions. The first reaction, 1x, and now we subtract the poilot. So it's 2 times x minus 1 meter. So if we calculate at 6 meters, we obtain a moment of minus 4 kilonewton meter. Now, as before, 1x minus 2 for x minus 1. And now we have the 3 kN load going up, so this is going to be a positive moment of 3 times x minus 6 meters. And now for m equal 8, we'll obtain a moment equal to 0. And last one, one x minus 2 times x minus 1 plus the 3 kN load x minus 6. And now we subtract 2 kN times x minus 8. Now, if we check for x equal 9, we should get 0. And if we put input the values, we get 18 minus 18, that's equal to 0. So this is correct. So that's all for today. I just solved the exercises of lesson 8. So please check your answers. Try them again if you need to. And if you have any issues, please leave me comments with questions and I will answer as soon as possible. Thank you for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe below the video to get notifications for all the future videos I'm preparing. And thank you very much for watching. Bye-bye.